be there to help you. I'll be right there by your side. Every time I will be your shelter when you need a place to hide. Like a page, and there will come a day. Just remember that I'm never far away. Just call my name, I'll be there for you. I'll be there for you. Such thing as ordinary, really we are quite contrary to everything that I thought I knew. So let's start a fire, I wanna keep you warm. Come and strike up the choir, throw open all the looked low and high, and I've never been so sure. I am yours. Won't you be mine?
There's a calm surrender to the rush of day, when the heat of the rolling world can't be turned away. An enchanted moment, and it sees me through. It's enough for this restless warrior just to be with you. And can you feel the love? It is where we are. It's enough for this wide-eyed wanderer that we've come this far. Can you feel the love? kings and vagabonds beneath the very best. Can you feel the love tonight? How it's lit. It's enough to make kings and vagabonds believe the very best. It's enough to make kings and vagabonds believe the best.
I believe we need a round of applause to make welcome our beautiful bride. Well, on behalf of Adam and Gretel, I am so very happy to welcome you here this evening to this beautiful setting as we celebrate the incredible love and happiness that they have found together. And we are also here to celebrate their journey into married life. I know that our happy couple are so excited to be sharing their promises to one another in marriage this evening. And what makes this day even more special is that they get to share it with all of you, because you are the family and the friends who mean the most to them. You have all played such a special part in helping shape them into the wonderful couple you see standing before you now. They're just having a little chat there, catching up. That's all right, as long as you're comfortable. I guess when we think about it, there really aren't many opportunities in life to get all of your favourite people together in the one place to celebrate love. And to be able to do this today as they formalise their union and celebrate just how much love they have for one another is what makes this day and this ceremony so incredibly special. Our bride and groom would like to start by thanking you all for making the effort to join them this evening, and we would like to give a special nod to our guests who have travelled from Portugal, Germany, Singapore, the United States, and from all over Australia. I won't get you to put your hands up, but thank you all for being here. Wherever it is that you have travelled from tonight, Adam and Gretel, thank you for spending your New Year's Eve with them. And they look forward to celebrating with you all tonight. So welcome all and thank you. We're going to start our ceremony now with some beautiful words on love and marriage, and these will be delivered by Adam's younger sister, Xiao Wei. So please come on down.
In marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should not end with the honeymoon. It should continue through the years. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers the whole family. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humour. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Xiao Wei. I believe we need a round of applause because that is quite a big ask. You can relax now and enjoy the ceremony. Exhale. Beautiful words in that reading, The Art of Marriage by Wilfred Peterson. So just to set the scene for what brings us all here this evening. Now, I think you probably all know Adam and Gretel's story, and they also captured this really beautifully on their wedding website. But we just want to set the scene for what brings us here tonight. Now, Adam and Gretel initially developed eyes for each other thanks to some brief encounters at a share house in Carlton. They've come a very long way. This was through their mutual friend, Dre. And Dre, I am going to get you just to raise your hand. He is the reason we are all here tonight. He was Gretel's housemate at the time. And he is now standing proudly beside our groomsman. Now, Adam said he was initially attracted to Gretel's carefree, fun and spontaneous nature. He loved and he still loves her beautiful smile and her incredibly kind heart. And Gretel was taken by Adam's confidence, and she recalls that when they first started dating, he was wearing a moon boot from a foot injury, and he even did that with style. She also loved his bright blue eyes. Obviously a winning combination with the moon boot. They recall that both were in a really exciting period of growth in their lives at the time, and they dated for several wonderful months. And this was before Gretel went off to Chile on exchange, and Adam took a six-month sabbatical to travel around the world. But after 5 months apart, they couldn't take it anymore, and they both knew that they wanted to be together again. And they met up in Rio, Brazil. They met up in an eco-hostel located in a pacified favela, very right on. But they quickly moved on to the Hilton in Copacabana Beach. They tried to rough it, they really did. And Gretel likes to call this beach Coco Banana Beach. Now, this was a far more romantic and fitting setting, and it was from here that their relationship really blossomed, and it just hasn't stopped. Since then, they've travelled the world, they've lived overseas, they have made wonderful lifelong friends. They've bought a beautiful home in South Yarra, one that they share now with the fine young fellow that you probably met on your way in, their corgi boy, their beautiful boy, Griffin. Did everyone say hello? The world's friendliest dog, I believe. It has been quite a journey for these two already, and they are only getting started. There is simply so much love between our bride and groom. I asked them to share with me some of the things that they love, that they admire, appreciate, and adore about one another. And we did have to edit it down quite strongly. So here are some things that they have shared with me. Adam loves Gretel's bubbly and caring way, the way she gets through life, always with a smile on her face. She treats everybody, no matter their position, with the same respect and always with warmth and courtesy. She is beautiful, inside and out. And he treasures that she has amazing values, strong convictions, and she always stands up for what she believes in. But mostly, Adam is inspired by the way, Gretel, that you manage to do it all, and you do it all with style. Adam says that being with Gretel helps and inspires him to become a better person and a much happier one too. And for Gretel, she admires Adam's self-awareness, his adventurous spirit, and his determination to grow and to always embrace and take on challenges. But mostly she loves the way that Adam supports her dreams and he always celebrates her successes. With Adam, Gretel feels like she can be the very best version of herself. These two love that they simply bring out the best in each other. And what more can you ask from a partner? Their relationship, they tell me, has at its heart love, of course. It also has a lot of trust. They're getting quite emotional out the back there already. It has trust, communication, and very importantly for these two, shared dreams and shared goals. They're not afraid to dig deep and to put in the work to make this relationship thrive. But at the same time, they also remind one another not to take life too seriously. And importantly, they always remember to tell one another how much they love and care for each other. Now, over the years, they love that they have become better people, and they have done that with one another's help, with one another's love. They have grown to love and appreciate one another more and more as the days go by. And these are all the things we are celebrating today. Now, looking forward, their hope is to continue throwing themselves into life. Their plan is to be great parents, to have amazing friends, I think they've succeeded already, to live a global lifestyle, and they're very passionate about wanting to give back to others as well. But running through all of this, through their plans for the future, is their commitment that they're about to make, and that is that they're going to cherish each other and the roles they play in one another's lives, knowing that it is together, hand in hand, side by side, as they are now, that will help them become absolutely everything that they hope to be. Sounds like a good plan, you two. Now, we have another reading here. This is an Irish, traditional Irish blessing, and this will be shared with us by Gratial's older brother, William. Please come forward.
May the road rise to meet you. May the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. The rain fall soft upon your fields, and until we meet again, may the universe hold you in the palm of his hand. May God be with you and bless you. May you see your children's children. May you be poor in misfortune, rich in blessings, and may you know nothing but happiness from this day forward.
Thanks, William. Nailed it. Now, I think we can see that family is very important to our bride and groom. We've had a lot of readings from the family, and they're also in our bridal party. And given that Adam and Gretel are indeed just about to create their own new family, they feel it is important here to acknowledge the unconditional love and the care given to them, especially by their parents, to Claire and Andrew, and also Marie and Trevor. Our bride and groom wish to thank you wholeheartedly for your ongoing love and for your support. We'd also like to acknowledge the very close connections that our bride and groom have with their siblings. You have each played such a special part in shaping them into who they are today, as only siblings can. We would also like to lovingly remember Gretel's grandparents, who played such a significant role in her upbringing and whose memory she still cherishes. So we thank you all for taking a moment to acknowledge those special people. All right, now we come to the vows. As we come to this formal part of the ceremony here, these two are very keen. Look at Adam's getting into position already. Stop talking, I want to get married. As we come to this formal part of the ceremony, I have to state here that my name is Georgia Milnes and I am duly authorised by law to solemnise this marriage according to the law. So, Gretel Rose Cannon and Adam Trevor Crewe, before you are joined in marriage today, in my presence and in the presence of all of your witnesses, I must remind you now of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship into which you are about to enter. Marriage, according to the law in Australia, is the union of two people to the exclusion of all others, and this is a relationship that you voluntarily enter into for life. They're nodding. Gretel's read the fine print. Please turn and face one another and join hands. Adam and Gretel, before you exchange your promises in marriage, I'm just going to share with you the words that you gave to me on what marriage and being married means to you both. You've shared with me that marriage means a commitment to one another that is enduring, one that necessitates love, care, understanding, and growth. You are making this commitment now, not because you need to, but because you wholeheartedly want to. You believe that in exchanging your promises in marriage, you strengthen this bond, your mutual commitment. And as you do this, you create a loving, nurturing partnership for your future. So with those words in mind, Gretel, I now ask, do you take Adam to be your husband?
I do.
That is correct. And Adam, do you take Gretel to be your wife?
I do.
Also correct, thank you.
I ask everyone here to witness that I, Gretel, take you, Adam, to be my lawfully wedded husband. I feel so lucky to be standing in front of you today, making this commitment before all our family and friends. You have helped me grow, supported me in everything I do, and loved me. Early on when we were dating, when I was scared of showing my affection for you, I told you I love the way you are. And to this day, it is true. I love your hugs when I am sad or when I am celebrating a success, and in random moments throughout the day to make me feel special. I adore the way you hold my hand whenever we are walking together and don't let go even when I'm being awkward. I'm so grateful for the way you celebrate my successes as your own and snowball ideas I have for the future with unbridled enthusiasm. I love the way you cook for me, and even if the meal is as simple as porridge, you develop a detailed strategy for the balance of flavours. As we take this next step together, I promise that I'll always listen to you and make sure you feel heard. I promise to try, although I may not succeed, to greet you, not Griffey, when I get home first when I get home. I promise to support you in all your endeavours and celebrate your successes as my own. And I promise to love you each day and never forget how lucky I am to be your wife.
I ask everyone here present to witness that I, Adam, take you, Gretel, to be my lawful wedded wife. Dear Gretel, you are the love of my life. You're my best friend, and my life is so much better with you in it. You're an amazing person, and you have the most incredible nature. You bring so much joy and laughter to my life and the lives of all the people you touch. I love how you are values-led, caring, fun, strong-willed, competitive, and driven. But most of all, I love when you collapse into my arms after a long day, tell me you love me, and I get a chance to work a problem with you and support you. You constantly inspire me, and I'm so grateful to have you in my life. I know with you that anything is possible and that everything will work out so long as we're in it together. I promise to keep our love sacred, to cook delicious meals, wipe down the bench after you, and put things back where they belong when you forget. I promise to never give up on us. And I promise to always support you to chase your dreams. I can't wait to live an amazing and adventurous life with you. I love you, and I promise to love and support you so long as we both shall live.
Well, thank you for sharing your beautiful promises to one another before all of us as your witnesses. You're now going to give one another wedding rings as a seal of those vows that you've just shared. And it's lovely to note here that your wedding rings have no beginning and no end. And they signify the continuation of your love. You will continue to choose each other to share your lives in marriage. So Dre, he's been there right from the start. He's still here. He's been given the honours to present the rings.
Adam, with this ring, I commit to a life with you, full of love, adventure, and support.
Team effort there, putting the ring on. Wonderful. And Dre, the other ring, please.
Gretel, with this ring, I commit to a life with you, full of love, adventure, and support.
Do they look different? A bit more relaxed. Well, Adam and Gretel, you have just exchanged your beautiful wedding vows to one another, and you have given one another wedding rings. And you've done this today surrounded by the love and blessings of all of your family and friends. And I invite you here just to take a moment to look out on how much love surrounds you today. The vows and the rings are the symbolic rituals and the legal promises that today formalise your union in marriage. But we know that the true work of your marriage will be in the way that you continue to live your lives. It will be in the way that you live your day-to-day lives. And we are excited to watch you grow and to thrive together, which I'm sure you will. Our wish is that you continue to journey through life side by side, guided by the words that you've shared here today and drawing on all of this love and support that surrounds you now. Look at their faces there. They know what words are coming next. It is with so much pleasure that I now pronounce you husband and wife. Congratulations, you may kiss.
Feel the cold of night. picture this, you and me, more alive than we've ever been. Wide awake, breaking free from the box of fitting in. So right now, we're not gonna waste another day. Right now, today, we're gonna run.
Absolutely adore the energy tonight. Well, now the long-awaited moment, I would like you to join me and bring your hands together to welcome the newly wedded couple, Adam and Gretel. The love that you share brings you together and enable you to stand beside one another when life is joyful, to share these moments together and stand even closer when life is challenging. Whenever we look at you both, we see how caring and supportive your love for one another is and how you stand together and look at the bright future you are creating one day after another for yourselves, your people, and your corgi. I was fortunate enough to cross your paths 4 years ago on Christmas Day. And from that day, I've been the happy witness of your commitments. Your commitment to your relationship. Your commitment to your future together. Your commitment to turn your dreams into reality. But also the commitment to yourselves. To grow and improve. To question, understand, and overcome. To become better individuals for yourselves, for one another, and for the people around you. This is admirable. And your love and commitment are paving the way to a bright, sparkling, and joyful future together. So let's just raise our glasses to Gretel and Adam. Andrew, quick question before we start. How was your main feeling walking Gretel halfway across down the aisle with Claire today?
Stable.
Firstly, that introduction by all of you dancing in was just fantastic, and it is wonderful for Claire and I to be here. For all of you who don't know me, I am Andrew Cannon, her father, very proud father of Gretel, and now the proud father-in-law of Adam. Firstly, thank you for Gretel for asking me to speak on this very special occasion. It is wonderful to look at you, and I've been looking at you all day to see how radiant and happy you are. And it makes a father proud when you know their daughter's happy, and today I can see that in your eyes, so thank you. It is also great to look around the room and see so many family and friends. So I know you've been there've been mention of people travelling around the world and coming from different places, but all of you mean a lot to us, and we're very proud to see you all here today as well. Gretel Cannon was born in small stature, but not in physical or mental strength. As an identical twin, Gretel and Grace have clearly grown close and enjoyed many great activities together. As a father in the early years, I was allowed brief times of sole parenting, which really became a survival course for Gretel. And sometimes sleeping on a boat with a little life jacket on, travelling to Europe or even going to Monaco, we had those early experiences which were just fantastic. As a proud father, I've watched Gretel achieve excellent results at the highest level, both in sport and academia, while holding a wonderful adventurous spirit, which they both share, and we know that that's been something that they've accelerated in and done lots of. Something Claire and I are very proud of as well. We do enjoy walking past the honour board at the first floor of the MCC, also referred to at home as Claire's house, and seeing her name in taking the most wickets in the women's first premier cricket season, something I'm proud of every time I walk up. She has also gone on to become very accomplished in hockey, representing the Singapore Cricket Club while residing there. When Gretel was at school, she filled her school life with as many activities as possible. As captain of sports, she also put her energy into the subject of philosophy, which my mother did as well. Whilst not winning any recognition from her school, she went on to win the Premier's Award for Excellence, presented by Ted Baillieu, which was a great, proud moment for her parents as well. Gretel's achievement in sport, academia and work clearly make her family proud. It is also wonderful to see the joy and love that Adam has brought to her. And the couple have already had a great journey together, travelling to South America and surviving difficult times in a very confined Singapore due to COVID. The two of them have continued to flourish through many of these challenges presented to them. And we as a family have continued to watch their partnership complement each other and grow stronger. It has also been wonderful to see Gretel's siblings, William, Elspeth and Grace, have all assisted Gretel so well in the last couple of weeks, getting ready for this exciting wedding. Now, 33 years ago, Claire and I got married. And I used to call her my auntie. John Stansfield's mother gave me this great advice. She said, to change the things that can be changed, to accept the things that can't, and to have the wisdom to know the difference. I really hope you value those words of wisdom and carry on to your life. I also would like to say that there are probably three of the most important things for happiness. Something to do, someone to love, and something to look forward to. I can see Gretel and Adam have all three. Adam, welcome to our family. Please look after my daughter. And I'll be keeping an eye on that. Friends and family, please be upstanding and join me in a toast as we welcome Gretel and Adam's union. I wish you all the best for the rest of your lives.
I have a quick question before we start. Same treatment as Andrew. How does it feel seeing Adam getting married today?
Wow, it was very emotional, I have to say. It was for me. I have to confess I'm a sook and I shed a tear there.
Oh, I barely kept it together. I feel you, Trevor. Please come with me.
Good evening. My name is Trevor Crew, and I am the proud father of the groom. You know, some things in life are just meant to be. And I would say that the marriage of Adam and Gretel was one of those things, just had to be. A beautiful couple, so much in love, radiant in every way. It was such a delight to see. We would like to, or I would like to, welcome Gretel into our family. We are pleased to have you as a member of our family. And also extend to Claire and Andrew the same invitation. I'm sure our paths will cross in the future as we have to share out those grandparental duties from time to time. You know, Adam at a young age demonstrated an ability to identify with right and wrong. And if it wasn't right, it was wrong. And if it was wrong, he had to fix it. And that was just the way he was. There was a time we went down to the lake to feed the ducks and the swans, right? And we were down there for a while. The ducks were quite fine. The swans became quite aggressive and very uncomfortable for the adults, right? But there was Adam, you know, 2 years of age, and he's going to feed the ducks and the swans. And his idea of fair play was it would be 50-50, some for the ducks, some for the swans. Fair enough. He's got that sussed. But this swan came out quite aggressively, you know, we're stepping back. Don't forget, Adam's two in nappies, and the swan is about the same height as he is. So, you know, we're squared off at the foreshore. Anyway, this swan decided that it would take the bread, all of it. Now, that wasn't fair. Adam, without even moving backwards, gave this swan a bit of a cuff across the beak. Now, I hasten to add, there were no animals injured in this story, okay? But nevertheless, that's what took place. And whilst we're all walking back, here's Adam, two nappies, with all these swans backing off saying, hey, who is this guy? Another tale I recall is that in his teens, he decided he wanted to be a DJ. He had it sussed. This was going to be his career path for sure. So he saved up all his money and he bought all the gear. And God, he had some gear, right? And he practiced relentlessly. And it was loud. It was very loud. But unbeknownst to me, he decided he would write to the neighbours and tell them who he was, what he was doing, and why he was doing it, and giving them a schedule of the times he was going to be doing it, which was mainly during the day, so that they could then determine whether they were going to be inconvenienced or not. Now, I don't know to this day whether anybody complained, but I can tell you a few of the neighbours collared me and said, we are so impressed that that young teenage boy would write and even consider us. Yeah, right. That's the truth of it. That's the way he was. A bit of a self-made man, a bit of a man's man. Clear vision, determined, has the discipline and the approach and the aggression and the empathy and all those qualities that go with making sure he was going to get to what he wanted to do. And you know, from what I've seen so far, I have to say I think Gretel's got exactly some of those qualities, which is a big part of why they get together. They've got together, right? Both of them have made a successful moves in their career. Gretel dealing in law that's complex, and that's a real credit to her. And Adam doing very well in his career path as well. I'm very proud of what he's achieved, and both of them. But I should give some words of advice. This will be interesting. Things don't always go as you planned. Some are good, some are bad. It matters not. What matters most of all is in the knowing that life will not deal you any hand at all that you can't handle. You might not like it. You might like it. You might not be ready for it. But in the knowing that I'll handle it will get you through most. As disappointing as some of it might be, and as elative as it might be in other senses. That's my advice to you, Gretel and Adam. Remain unified. As a unit, you can handle anything that comes your way, and it will. We wish you all the very best for the future, whatever that may bring you. We send you all our love from our side of the family. Thank you, everyone.
It's so wonderful to be here. You're a great crowd. I'm really happy that that's the case. When Adam asked me to say a few words tonight, I asked my daughter for a little advice on what I should say. She said, Mum, you'll be fine, just don't try to be funny. I'll do my best on it. Sorry, I try. My glasses I have to put on and off. I might just stay here and just not move. What an absolute delight it is to be here celebrating with Gretel and Adam. I'm so very proud. Adam was born a 38-week, 7.5-pound baby that could not breathe on his own. He needed 100% oxygen, and by the end of day two, we were told there was nothing else they could do. It was now up to him. On the morning of day three, we decided to name him. He would be Adam with two Ds for strength, and it worked. I felt a little bit better after that, that we actually gave him a name he'll have to spell for the rest of his life. I remember Adam's first year one school athletics carnival, and the boys were all lining up for the race. And Adam's teacher, Mrs. Lee, the boys will remember her, leant over to me and said, "Your son's got that look in his eye again." I looked over at you, gave you a little wave, and she said, "That look, you know that look. I'm going to win this race or I'm going to die trying." I don't remember if he won that race, but I do know I've seen that look in his eye many times. When we decided to come to Melbourne, Adam wasn't sure whether he would join us. He thought he may stay and finish his degree in UWA, and we had many discussions on that and many topics of things. And one that stands out for me the most was the discussion around friendships and girlfriends. And I remember saying to him, "One day you will meet someone who is intelligent, like you. She will be ambitious, like you. She will strive to be educated and to gain knowledge, like you. She will be beautiful, loving, caring and kind, just like you. And you will reflect back to each other those wonderful qualities. And sometimes you will reflect back to each other some little things that may need some work." All right? "But together you will grow and you will create the most magnificent life. And here we are. I love you, my beautiful Tuxie, and I love your beautiful bride. Congratulations, darling."
All right. Good evening, everyone. Firstly, wow, what an incredible ceremony, and what a beautiful now married couple. A big thank you to the happy couple, our family, and my new brother-in-law's family for making today so special. We all know organising a wedding doesn't happen overnight, and so every touch made it all so worth it. It's an absolute honour to stand beside my twin sister as she embarks on a new and exciting chapter of her life. As someone who is Gradle's original other half, I know... I know how lucky you are, Adam, to go through life with Gradle by your side. Gradle, I've always admired your bravery. When we were kids, you were always climbing the highest tree. You taught the VCE philosophy class you were supposed to be taking. You moved to Singapore. You fly through trees on your skis without a single practice. As a bit of a scaredy cat myself, having you as a guinea pig is fantastic. I love seeing how Adam is not only watching on board as you travel through your next adventure, but jumps right on board. Any small, nutty idea, Adam, you want to make it happen. Gradle, you're one of the most determined people I know. If you set your mind to anything, good luck to anything in your side, in its way. Adam, your approach to life is no different. You could even give Gradle a run for her money. I cannot wait to see where your shared drive and determination lead you in the years to come. I believe what to look for in a life partner is someone who brings out the best version of yourself. You can always have fun with on wonderful adventures or the mundane everyday things. And someone who supports you and you can rely on them. Adam, over the past few years, I've seen Gradle thrive. You're both kicking goals. Griff's puppy classes. Your beautiful home. Adam, your impressive cooking skills and both your numerous work promotions. Together, you've travelled the world as well as survived very serious lockdowns in a small one-bedroom apartment. A testimony to all your adventures is all the beautiful friends who are here today, many of whom have travelled across the world. Lastly, I see you, Adam, support Gretel in everything she does. If that's just buying morning croissants, picking Gretel, and maybe me up too, from a party where we've had too much champagne, or new work directions, you're right by her side. In preparation for this speech, I thought it was a good idea to read Bono's book on 40 years of marriage. It wasn't. I think you two are as prepared as ever for your next step, and you really don't need a book. I'm so excited for where this new contract of love will take you, and thank you so much for involving me in your special day.
All right, Tuxie, my boy. When I sat down to write this, I couldn't think where to begin. How do I put into words the feelings and the memories I have of our incredible life together and how much you truly mean to me? To set the context for everyone else, Tuxie's been my best friend and younger brother for 33 years. Our partnership began as kids in Perth, with Mum dressing us in the exact same clothes every day. We had to look out for each other. Life was easy. We spent our childhood eating two-minute noodles, watching Hulk Hogan, exploring uncharted grasslands around our home, and starting WrestleMania matches with the other kids in the street. Now, as I'm sure you can appreciate, winning those was very important for family supremacy. So we did that together. Our teenage years were much the same, albeit our lives had changed drastically. We now not only had each other, but our beautiful younger sister, Xiao Hui, aka the Woz, aka Shouds. We love you, Shouds. Woz's introduction to our life meant we watched every Disney movie that ever existed on repeat. Many times. And when we weren't watching Shrek with Shouds, Tux and I skateboarded or rollerbladed. We moved our computers into the same room so we could fulfill our potential dream of being esports superstars. And during that time, our taste buds had really matured to enjoy the finer things like Chicken Treat and the Colonel. And we did it all together. As young adults, we set our sights on becoming superstar DJs. Spending hours playing and mixing music, we partied at events and drum and bass gigs and hung out with each other's friends. Even when I moved out of home, it was as if Tuxie had moved out too. We were together. In 2019, Tuxie moved to Melbourne. It was the first thing we didn't do together, and it was hard. Whilst I missed him tremendously, watching the growth he went through during that time made it okay. Finishing uni, starting a career, maturing into a fine young man, and figuring out what he wanted from life. Finally, we reunited in Sydney years later, and we got to live together again. I got to meet all these new amazing friends, lots who are here today and have become my close friends, and I got to see firsthand the beautiful man he'd become. But most importantly, we were together again. I love you so much, Tuxie. It doesn't matter what mood I'm in or where I am in the world, I know when we speak, I'll always feel better. You're so determined and headstrong, yet so soft and caring, and you're always working to be a better version of yourself. You've always cared so much about the people around you, and I know this, and I know everyone feels it, and I know this because I've felt it. And in a world where everyone needs a protector, whether you know it or not, you've been mine. Your pursuit of happiness and knowing what you want has ultimately led you to your beautiful wife, Gretel. From a love that started as friends, which turned into meeting up on overseas while traveling, to ultimately moving to Singapore and then back to Melbourne. I've watched you fall in love with someone who is far more intelligent than you, who challenges you, and also who loves you. Gretel, we are so happy to officially have you as part of the crew. Hey. It took a long time to think up. The profound impact you've had on Tux, creating balance, humility, and calm in him, is how I know you were made for each other. We're all excited to watch the journey life takes you both on. No doubt it will be filled with lots of travel, laughter, love, and hopefully a few more cannon crews in the family. I hope you both know that no matter where you end up, I'll always be here for both of you and just a phone call away. I forgot my champagne, but I'll pretend. So if everyone could please raise their glasses to Gradle and Tuxie. How good does my wife look? We really wanted to say thank you to everyone who's come tonight. It means the world to us to have all of you here from all over the world. If you're in this room, it's because you mean something to us, and we're really glad we get to share this evening with you. So thank you. Please give yourselves a round of applause.
We'd like to thank everyone that has made today possible. Our parents, so mum and dad, so Claire and Andrew, Trevor and Marie, and our groom and bridal party. You all mean the world to us, and it's been so special to share today and every other day that we've had preparing and, you know, bringing this day together with you all. So thank you.
Come away with me in the night. Come away with me and I will write you a song. Come away with me. Come away where they can't tempt us with their lies. And I want to walk with you on a cloudy day in fields where the yellow grass grows knee high. So won't you try? Come away with me and we'll kiss on a mountain top. Come away with me and I'll never stop loving you.